Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers, my sisters, many people commit sins and thereafter they change their lives. So when we were young, we committed sins, we were embarrassed of some of the things we've done, and we then change our lives later on. As we grow up, we become people who are more conscious of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in your teen years, as you grew up, perhaps in your early 20s, when you hadn't yet turned to Allah, you did some embarrassing things. Sometimes people get involved sexually with others, astaghfirullah, may Allah protect us. Sometimes people, go into pornography, may Allah protect us. Sometimes some people begin to send, their friends nude pictures of themselves, may Allah protect us. Sometimes people actually get involved in relationships that are very, very toxic. Later on, they realize sometimes they make mistakes. Sometimes they even involve in sins that are like shirk and away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They begin to, say things or do things that are really, really bad, whether it's drugs, whether it's alcohol, whatever else it may be. And later on, they regret. And they regret. That regret is actually something that perhaps stems from your relationship with Allah. Remember, Adam alayhi salam committed a very, very grave sin. He actually disobeyed the instruction of Allah regarding food. He consumed that which was haram for him. He consumed it in a way that displeased Allah, because Allah had expressly warned him about shaitan, shaitan's plan. Allah told him so much. Allah told him, watch out, this guy is really dangerous and so on. But he fell. Adam alayhi salam and Hawa, Adam and Eve, they fell. When they fell, what happened? They were not doomed suddenly. They were given a chance to repent. As soon as they uttered the words, "O Allah, we have wronged ourselves," so they admitted their sin and they are expressing their remorse. "And if you don't forgive us, we're going to be from among those who are losers." رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَّمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. O Allah, O our Rabb, we have wronged ourselves. If you don't forgive us, if you don't have mercy on us and forgive us, then we're going to be from among the losers. When Allah heard that, He became so happy. He accepted their repentance. He accepted the forgiveness. He forgave them. He wiped out their sins. Yes, He sent them onto the earth and the plan started. O son of Adam, whenever you've committed a sin, have hope in the mercy of Allah enough that you know you will be forgiven by the Lord, who is the most merciful, the most forgiving, the most kind, the most compassionate, the most loving, the most beneficent, and so on. If you don't believe in those names of Allah, you don't know Allah. So if you think that, oh, my past is haunting me, I'm too embarrassed, I'm going to be punished by Allah, I'm going to be exposed by Allah. Why are you worrying? When Allah covered you while you were sinning, do you really believe He's going to expose you while you're seeking forgiveness? Now, I want to say something. Shaitan is terrible. He keeps coming to our lives, even after we've changed our lives, and he keeps telling us, you know what, you're not good enough. You're going to be exposed one day. You're going to be... So he creates this anxiety in us, yet the sin is wiped out by Allah. The first time we sought forgiveness, the sin was totally wiped out, completely wiped out. So when we sought the forgiveness and the sin was wiped out, how do we go back to losing hope in the mercy of Allah, when Allah warns you, "La taqnatu min rahmatillah"? Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. I want to tell you that losing hope in the mercy of Allah is a bigger sin than the sin that you have committed, perhaps, because no matter what sin you have committed, the mercy of Allah is broader than that sin. Allah says, "Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a." Allah will forgive all the sins, including shirk and association of partnership with Allah, if it were committed during your life and you had sought the forgiveness of Allah during that life and you changed your ways, Allah will wipe it out. The only time Allah don't forgive shirk is if you were to die in the condition where you did not seek forgiveness from sins. Everything Allah can forgive, even if you didn't seek forgiveness from it. If you've died in that condition, He may forgive it besides shirk. That's all. That's the meaning of the term, "Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih." that Allah will not forgive that which is association of partnership with Allah. But He will definitely forgive it if you sought forgiveness in your life. When Allah says He won't forgive it, He is only referring to having died in the condition without seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. In which case, He will forgive everything else. But this one, He says, this I won't forgive. That's up to Allah. He can do what He wants. He can say what He wants. But He still says He's the most merciful, the most forgiving, the most kind, the most compassionate, the most loving, the most, the most. Do you believe in the names of Allah? Have you recognized Allah? Do you know Allah is the most loving, the most loving, the most kind, the most merciful, the most compassionate, the most beneficent? Do you believe that? If you believe that Allah is the most in all these characteristics, then you're a true believer. Then you will smile. You know that the weakness of man is such that we commit sin and we seek forgiveness. People commit sin every day. Allah says, I will forgive them every single day. People commit sin every night. Allah says, I will forgive them every single night. Subhanallah. For as long as they seek that forgiveness. So don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. One of the traps of the devil is he makes you become haunted by your past, where people suffer OCD as a result. They're depressed, they cannot eat, they cannot drink because of something they did when they were 20 years old. Perhaps you may have lost your virginity. May Allah protect us. So many young girls actually message saying, you know what, I unfortunately fell, I committed this and did that, and now I don't know what. Don't become depressed. Forgiveness is for you too. Allah will forgive you, subhanallah. And Allah will definitely open your doors, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His doors are definitely open. It does not mean you are doomed. It does not mean that, you know, you need to be whipped, etc. All that, you need to just seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember this. You need to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're living in conditions that are trying, that are very testing. There is a lot of pressure to do a lot. Look at the people who are on drugs. Look at the people in the gambling casinos. Look at the people who are gambling away their earnings and their livings. Look at the people who are drinking alcohol and intoxicating themselves. You know, the degree of intoxication is such that it's unimaginable. But you know what? Allah says, my doors are open. My doors are wide open. I will forgive. I will keep on forgiving. I will continue to forgive. But never think that I'm not forgiving. That's not one of the names of Allah. Allah's name does not include he who doesn't forgive, he who punishes, you know, meaning he who is going to punish you and that's it. No. In fact, it's the other way around. Allah chooses for himself. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most kind, the most forgiving, the most merciful, the most beneficent. Like we say, the one whose mercy encompasses everything, and he has a specialized mercy for those who believe. So don't let your past haunt you. You need to smile at the fact that you have a Lord who is absolutely merciful. Your past is your past. That's exactly what it is. It's not your present. It's not going to be your future. So if there is a bad habit or something you did in the past, it's gone. It's over. Allah's not going to punish you now that you sought forgiveness. When you seek forgiveness once, that was enough. We repeat it. We say it again and again and again. The first time was enough. It wiped your sin out. The second time, it elevates your status. It's not like that sin still exists. At-ta'ibu min adh-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lah. The messenger, peace be upon him, says the one who seeks forgiveness from a sin is equivalent to the one who never ever committed that sin before. So please, my brothers, my sisters, don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. No matter what you've done, you are still the beloved servant, slave of Allah, the beloved creature of Allah. He loves you. He made you. He's waiting for you. He actually does not want you to lose hope in his mercy. So remember this, my brothers and sisters, the trap of the devil is when you have sought forgiveness, he comes back to you and makes you doubt the mercy of Allah, which is a bigger sin than whatever you've committed in the past because you haven't even recognized Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease and open our doors. These are a few words. I'm going to post them onto my YouTube channel. The YouTube channel is youtube.com/muftimenk, R-O-X. R-O-X is rocks, Mufti Menk rocks. I don't rock, but actually that was created by a brother Hassan Shabir from Canada many, many years back. And he handed that over to me, and that's how it became the channel. So don't blame me for the name, but in actual fact, it's just a beneficial channel. I hope you can subscribe to that channel, inshallah, so that you can be updated every time I post something on YouTube, and I'm trying to do it as best as I can. Let's try and have a lesson a day. Inshallah, 10 minutes to 15 minutes, and that's it. And you can listen to it at any time of the day by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to try. It's a challenge. I know because of my obligations and my travel and so on, it may not be possible, but I'm going to try. At least we squeeze in 5 every week. 10-minute sessions where we can talk about these topics. You need something to be spoken about, you can email me, muftimenk@gmail.com. I will try to speak about that topic. And there is nothing that we won't speak about for as long as it's relevant and for as long as I also agree that we need it and we need it to be spoken about, then inshallah we're going to speak about it. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and so on. I just want to quickly say a prayer for the sister who is saying, I've been married for 16 years without a child. May Allah bless you with whatever is best for you. You need to firmly believe that Allah knows what is best for you. There are people with children who are so upset. There are people with only boys who are so upset. There are people with only girls who are so upset. Some people's children have let them down in a way that they wish they didn't have children. And here we are, when Allah has protected us from something by perhaps holding it back from us, we are still complaining. That doesn't mean you should not keep on trying and you should not keep on having hope in the mercy of Allah, because the extended hope and the extended trial will actually earn you paradise because of your hope in the mercy of Allah and your belief that Allah will only do that which is best. That's what will get you to paradise. Sorry for speaking so quickly. One of the sisters emailed me saying, you're speaking too fast. I forgot about it, but inshallah, next time I will speak a little bit slowly. I'm so sorry, sister. And I really think your advice was correct. I appreciate the fact that you told me to speak a little bit slowly. I'm sorry, today I didn't. I don't know why I was in a rush. But I really pray that Allah bless every one of you. We don't need to suffer anxiety and depression and stress over a sin we've committed when we were little or in our past, even if it was yesterday. You don't need to become, once you've sought the forgiveness of Allah, it's done, it's over, it's closed, it's wiped out, it is history, it is the past. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all a good death. Jazakumullah khair, my brothers and sisters. Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.